Hello, you're in Public Spot. I'm George. Welcome to part 2 of a series of videos where I show you how I build a simple system using event-driven architecture. Previously, I showed you how I built a simple backend API that generates a thumbnail from a URL of an image. And on this video, I will show you how I build a worker service using a Python module called Celery. If you're new to this channel, welcome. Make sure you hit that subscribe button. Enough of the chat. Let's start coding. As usual, I will build my worker service using TDD. So I'll break this down into two separate tasks. First task is to create my entity code, which will have the code that performs the main functionality. And then the second task is to create the main worker code that will end up consuming the messages from the broker system. So firstly, I need to create my requirements file. And in this file, I'll add the PyTest module. And then I'll create three directories: entities, tests, and workers, and then I'll create an empty init file on each of these directories. So now that I have my requirements file and my directories set up, I'll go ahead and activate my virtual environment so I can start writing my test cases and my code. And now inside my tests directory, I'll create a new file and call it tests_entities.py and write my first test cases. So I'm instantiating a thumbnail object in here, which I expect to have a property called URL and file name. And then the assertion that I've set in here is that these properties have to be the same as what I pass as the URL and file name. And then I also set a call to a create method, which I expect to be the method that actually creates the image or the thumbnail. And then I have an assertion in here to check that the file was created after a successful call. So let me open my terminal and start running my test. So the test failed. Let's have a look at what the error is. And it says module not found error. So we need to create that class. So let's open Explorer. And then inside my entities directory, I'll create a new file here called thumbnail.py. In here is a class implementation called thumbnail. I set an init method to set the URL and file name properties. And I also set an empty create method. Let me open my terminal and run my test again. And the test still failed. So let's have a look at what the failure is. And it's failing on the last assertion that checks that the file was created. So I need to implement the create method, but I'm not going to reinvent the wheel because we already have an implementation from the previous video. But firstly, I need to update my requirements file for the modules that I need for this to work. So requirements.txt. So now that I've updated my requirements file, I need to go ahead and reinstall all the modules. I need to go back to my thumbnail.py and finish up on the implementation. So let's quickly talk about what I've done in here. So first thing is I've actually imported all the modules that I need for my code. And then in here, my implementation for the create method is basically the same as what we've implemented in the backend API that we built from the previous episode, except that the URL and the file name is actually pulled out of the objects property that we set in the init method. The other thing that I need to update in here is that we don't have a size property inside my class object as well as a static dir. So let's go ahead and update that. With that implementation, let me go back to my terminal and run my test again. So everything is passed. Now I also need to account for exceptions, so I need to update my test case. So let's talk about the exception assertions that I've done in here. So like what I did in the backend API, I actually tested the scenarios where the URL provided is not an image, as well as the URL not being a valid URL. My first test case is an assertion that unidentified image error is raised when I provide a URL that's not an image. And then the other one is handling a missing schema exception if the URL is invalid. With that said, let me go back to my terminal and run my test again. So one fail in my test. Let's have a look at what the error is. And it's complaining about the PyTest module not being imported. So let me go ahead and fix that. Save changes and run test again. And everything is passed. So now that I have my entity class created, I can now move to creating my workers. So I need to add the Celery module to my requirements file because that's the module that I'll be using. So let's open my Explorer, and then inside my test directory, I'll create a new test file for my Celery config. The first thing that you'll notice here is that I'm importing an object inside workers config, and then in my assertion, I'm verifying that the app-conf broker URL and app-conf result backend properties are not null. Let me go back to my terminal and run my test. So it failed. Let's have a look at the error is. It says no module name workers config. So let's open my Explorer. Inside my workers directory, I'll create a new file called config.py. This implementation, I am instantiating an object for class Celery, and then I set up some properties of my configuration for that Celery app with broker URL, pulling the value from an environment variable called broker, and then the result backend also pulls the value from an environment variable called backend. So let me go back to my terminal, clear this, then run my test again. So everything is passed. What I need to do next is to create my test case for my worker. Let's open my Explorer, and inside my test directory, so what I've set up in here as a test case is for my worker with a method called create and an assertion of file being created after the call to create. So let me open my terminal and run my test. Let's have a look at what the error is. And it's complaining about thumbnail not being available inside workers. So let's open my Explorer, and then inside my workers, I'm going to create a file called thumbnail.py. Let's quickly have a look at what I've done in here. So first is I've imported the app object inside my config module, and then I also imported the thumbnail class from entities.thumbnail. And then I set the create block as a task by adding this method decorator. So I need to update the parameter of the method and add self. Let me go back to my terminal and run my test again. That test failed. Let's have a look at what the error is. So it's complaining about a missing module called config, and that's because it has the reference from inside the same directory. So all we have to do is add a dot before config. Save changes, go back to my terminal, and then run my test again. So all test cases have passed. At this point, I'm all set to dockerizing my application. So let me close all this code that we have in here. And then in the root of my workspace, I'll create a Docker config file. With my Docker config file all set, I'll create my Docker compose file to integrate all components together. So in my Explorer, in the root of my workspace, I'll create a Docker compose YAML file. This Docker compose file, I have set up a RabbitMQ service which my worker service will be dependent on, as you would see in here. There is also another service that I would like to be integrated in here, and it's called Flower, which is a tool that would allow me to view what's happening in the broker system. So this would mainly show which workers have consumed messages and the status of processing. Let me go ahead and update my Docker compose file to integrate this Flower service. So let me open my terminal, here it is, and I'll start issuing Docker compose up. So my Docker Compose failed. Let's have a look at the error. So it looks like the backend's property of my worker service has been set up incorrectly. So let me go ahead and fix that. So in my Docker Compose, go to my worker service, and then the backend environment variable cannot be set as an MAQP. Let me run my Docker Compose again. Looks like everything has been started successfully. Let me just quickly show you how the flower service looks like. So in my Docker Compose file, I have made the flower service accessible on port 888. So what I'm going to do is I'll open browser, navigate to localhost 8888. So this is how flower service looks like. I only have one worker, and if I navigate through that link, it will show me details of my worker service. I won't be getting into much detail on how this service is used, but what I want to do next is to try to get my worker service to consume a message from the broker system and perform the thumbnail creation that I have built earlier. So I'll go back to my VS Code. Let's cancel this and stop all my Docker Compose services. And then we need to go back to my Docker Compose file, fix the configuration for my RabbitMQ service. So in here, I need to expose all the ports that I need to be able to access RabbitMQ on my local machine. And then run my Docker Compose services again. Worker service is now ready to accept messages. So let me open a new terminal. And then in here, I'll export. And note that I have to change RabbitMQ to localhost. And then export backend. And then now I'll start a new Python shell, and then I'll import the worker module that I need to use. And then I'll start dropping a message into my broker system. So the async result has been displayed. And then list the files inside my temp static directory. It will show me the file that was created. This is file from broker, which is an indication that my worker service is working. That's it for today. Next time, I'll put together both the backend and worker services and set up my final application, so stay tuned. In the meantime, let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Share the video to anyone who you think might find this useful. And lastly, don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Until next time, see ya.